Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. A couple of questions sent in today about page setup. If we go into File, Page Setup, and we say that we want to have a certain rows to repeat at top, for example, rows 1 through 3. Someone said, well, hey, can we always have certain rows repeat at the bottom or certain columns to repeat at right? No, Excel will only let you repeat at the top and the left. And then the second question said, well, in my rows to repeat at top, I have a page number. How do I make that dynamically change on each page? And I think we're trying to use the wrong thing here. If we go into File, Page Setup, let's go to the Header Footer tab, and in the custom header, we can choose that we want to see page, you know, whatever, page 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that shows up in the header, and then we don't need to have that showing up over here in cell E1. We can actually get rid of that. So we can get rid of it here, and then when we look in Page Break Preview, there is page 1 and then page 2. Now, of course, we have a header and we have a footer, so you can actually have something repeat at the bottom of every page. Don't have any good way to repeat columns at the right of each page, but by using header and footer, we can certainly use the top and the bottom, and it'll be a dynamic page number that'll change from page to page to page. You know, so many times in Excel, there's many different ways to do things, and it appears that using that area to print at top, rows to repeat at top, might be a good way to put a page number in. But when you get right down to it, there's another way, the header and footer, which are actually better in this particular case. Well, I hope that helps. Thanks to you for stopping by, and we'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.